some herringe.
This horse mane with synthetic.
Oh, okay.
Is that calligraphy or painting?
It's both.
It's both?
Yeah, Zen. Zen brush. Is it expressionistic brush or spontaneous brush? Mm. So, yeah, you can like doing the whole thing with one stroke, basically.
Well,
you can wet the canvas if you like with it. If you use of the whole body of the brush, you know, like the heel,
yeah,
you can get all the gradation, kind of thing. Yeah.
What's this?
So. It's a Zen brush, so you won't get a point. Maybe, yeah, yeah, you.
I left more in it.
Yeah, you have to soak it completely. You got the point. Yeah, yeah.
Like down in the base.
Right, right.
You're trying to get it up under here.
Right. If the heel is not wet, you won't get point. Yeah.
Yeah, now it's pointing up.
Yeah.
That's gotta. You gotta get it.
Now you got point. Yeah. It also takes a little time. It will become even softer after 10 minutes. So some calligraphers said the best time is like within 20 minutes or after 5 minutes, so that's the best, you got best resilience and flexibility, yeah.
Well, with this, you don't need, there's really no need to get a fine brush to lay things in with or to do a drawing with, because mm-hmm. Look at the, how, I don't. Well, that's really, see the little hairs in there? Just leave them.
Yeah, new brush comes with some loose hair.
I like them.
Yeah, just add some
okay.
Texture.
I'm gonna go for the next value. And with watercolor, you need to get it pretty dark. Or, you can go over it again. But yellow, red, yellow, blue. Let's see what we come up with here. That's going to dry quite a bit lighter. Remember my last one, I made it lighter so things would recede. Let's get some. Something dark on there. That's kind of violet, so if I throw a little bit of yellow in there, it should gray it. Mm-hmm. Now I'm going for that edge. I don't always do this in oil because a lot of times in oil they come back and do the edge later. In watercolor, I usually do it as I'm going. We have this next one. It's a little darker, a little redder. and some greens in there. But they really don't separate that much. We've got this hillside here. This brush is fast. Woo! And fun. Oh boy. Now we've got these guys in the foreground. I'm gonna go for it here. Because you kinda have to. Right up here in the foreground. I think I hit some black in there, didn't I? Which I don't usually do. Here's a lesson on black. Add some other stuff to it. That really came out black. Some other stuff to it, like see, if you put black all by itself, it doesn't work usually very well, but if you put it down with other color, it looks great. Bluer greens are on the ground. It's watercolor, you just gotta roll with it. Here's one of my little things, too. Sometimes I suck it up with the brush. Sometimes I just pull it off with a rag like that. This light green down in there, on the ground. I want to just by just lifting it, you made it lighter. Unfortunately, it's not as saturated as I'd like it. So I can come back with the yellow. This yellow glaze on top of that. Oops, that's going to be something else. I like it though. Not what I asked for though. But I didn't really change the value too much where it resaturates it. I want to go back to this. This stuff is really potent. And I want that trunk, because I know it's going to dry lighter, so I want that trunk to really time doing the trunk first. I didn't even know I was going to do that, by the way. And other times I might do it the same way I did the oil. You don't have to have an exact science on everything you do. I know a lot of artists that would disagree with me on that, though. And they don't paint like me either. For better or worse. They would say for better. But I don't like their results, you know? I get really spontaneous results because I am spontaneous. I just but things happen. I'm gonna take this one right off the top here. So if I want a more sensitive tip, what I can do is just take this, lay it down and roll it, and then back into a nice tip. And this is what's so great about working with a big brush like this, is I can just fantastic effects around this. To my tree zen mode there for a minute. I'm back now. How long was I gone? Like an hour, Rob. Side of the brush. Yeah, it goes quick. It goes so quick that you might want to not look away for a second. Just joking. But when you're doing it, it goes so quick when you use the side of your brush like this that you might want to just actually slow down, because you're going to cover really fast and you can just make a big mess. Slow down. See all of this crumbly stuff around the edges? Instant oak tree.
Yeah.
Better just to slow down. Even though I'm going really slow, it'll be done in just a minute. Slowing down, taking my time. Yeah. Any brush, just use the tip for linear things. See? Look at that. This brush is amazing. Look at it. I just went from a needle. That's an eyelash. Right? From an eyelash. And I'm only using like a quarter of the brush here to do this. If I laid this thing all the way down, I could do one of those big masses in just like one quick little, you know. But why would I want to do that? I don't know. Okay. Take it right off the table. See, I have all this weight there now. What I did on the other one is I countered it with these other two guys that were sticking out of the room. Do the other things. Again, just lay it down and turn the brush. Lay it down and turn the brush. You'll get a nice point. Might have got some oil paint in there. Oh well. We'll figure it out. Okay. All these blue or greens here. I'll throw them in there. Probably gonna go for some blue green. Ooh, let's try that. That's interesting. Just like that. Now, if I wanted more of that exact, I like this blue. But if I wanted more of that exact color, just add some yellow to it. And those guys. Just remember, it's saturated now, but it'll desaturate as it dries. But it's watercolor. Oh man, that is so cool. We just got semi-opaque there.
It's mineral colors.
Mineral?
Yeah, opaque color.
I love it. Why not? They get a little darker at the base. I don't even know what this is, but it looks darker. This is a classic composition. You have the big mass here being balanced out by the small mass here, which is pointing us back into the composition here. Very, you'll see this over and over and over.
Is this a steelyard?
Yeah, it you could call it a steelyard composition. Some people also refer to it as a kind of a tunnel going on here too. So see, you almost have a tunnel-like composition going there too. So after a while, you learn these little frameworks. Some people call this, they call it steel yard. If you look that up, it's a compositional type. After a while, when you play with them for a while, you'll start improvisating on them and developing your own little versions of them. So they're, and that's really, not only does it get fun there, but you're not so, like if you do a perfect steelyard composition, usually it looks kind of stale. Almost any composition that you do perfectly looks kind of stale. So you improvise on them and you play with them and you see, you mix it up and see what you come up with. And okay, so couple little dark things, just that we need a few little diagonals in there. Just directing the eye around.
What?
He shared that much information with you, huh? Wow.
That's cute.
Let's see what else we got next.
Cool.
Now, because these will dry a little bit lighter on the top like this, what I can do is come in with maybe something blue, maybe something sort of violet-ish on the bottom, and then dry brush in my sort of shadows up and underneath things. All of these sort of gives them a little bit of form. We have the shadow at the base. And you want to wait for them to dry. These aren't quite dry, but you know, it's okay. Let your gut be the judge of how dry it has to be. And I can do this idea right here of giving these a little more light and shadow. I could come back and hit the base of all of these like this. Oh, man. I think it gets a little bit contrived. So I like to mix it up with a few different colors. There we go. Oh yeah, and a good rag in there once in a while, just to keep it kind of natural looking. So you see, we just have light and shadow. Maybe it needs a couple more hiccups in there, you know. I'm just kind of randomizing the light and shadow a little bit more. Change the color once in a while. These decisions go really fast. There are things you'll want to take a little more time on, though, and think about. Paint them fast, but think about them. Do you want to put it in? Do you not? I don't know. Don't think too much, though. You know what I mean? Think about them, but don't think too much. Well, I don't think anyone here has got the analysis paralysis problem. And some people just analyze until they're paralyzed. See, I shot a little branch through that hole. I'll do that here and there, you know, just kind of. Not everywhere, but just here and there. Those are just decisions that I just. I'm thinking I need something through here. But I like that open area, so I don't want to mess with it too much. That was big. Maybe that's enough. I really like that shot of red back there. Nice flat shapes. Like that. Just think that these need to be reinforced a little bit more. And honestly, I look at what's up there, but as I don't know if you can see what I'm looking at, but most of the time, I would say probably 3/4 of my time, I'm not even looking at it. I'm just using it for just a inspiration, you know? It's the whole reason to be out and paint. And sometimes what I'll do is I'll lay in a big flat thing like that and just come back in. This is one thing you can do with watercolor, really nice. Lose and find the branch. Yeah, just lost and found. Morning. Yeah. I got a little friend there.
Yeah, that's nice bird.
Decided to join the party.
Maybe you should add a figure, walker.
I don't know if that would work. Really. I think that's great. What do you think?
Yeah. Is that red already a signature? It looks like a signature already. Oh, yeah. See, you don't need the sign. You already did.
Yeah, you did.
It kind of melted in there, but it's a nice place for it.
It serves as a bush and a signature at the same time. I can't believe it. It works.